Events in Ohio developed without regard for the Crown's position. Neither Washington nor the Virginian governor had any intentions to resolve the conflict through diplomatic negotiations. Instead, they reinforced the garrison of Fort Necessity to 400 men and sent out regular troops from South Carolina. Washington was confident he would easily repel any enemy attacks. However, when about 1,000 French and Native American troops approached Fort Necessity on July 3rd, it became clear that the fort was very badly situated. The French made their stand on the heights around Fort Necessity, and neither walls nor trenches could protect the defenders. Washington realized there was no point in offering further resistance and surrendered. An open war broke out on all frontiers between Britain and France in North America. In the winter and spring of 1755, both countries sent regular troops. Taking advantage of these reinforcements, the governor of Virginia decided to attack Fort Duquesne. In summer, about 2,000 men under the command of General Braddock moved out. In the morning of July 9th, Braddock forded the Monongahela without any resistance from the French side. As they moved along, the terrain became more and more enclosed, and when they reached a passage between two mountains, the French attacked. With 900 units, they entrapped Braddock, and heavy fire rained down upon his troops. The panic-stricken British soldiers fled towards the crossing, where the survivors crossed back over the river.